Spider-Man Far From Home is the end to Marvel's Phase 3. It takes place quite literally minutes after the events of Avengers Endgame. The story concludes the multi-phase Infinity Saga that began with 2008's Iron Man film. Today, we're going to see what Marvel's Phase 4 has in store, with evidence and logic supported by the three previous phases of movies. Before we begin, though, let me thank you for watching JLS Comics and pressing play. If you like videos like this, don't forget to hit the like button, and if you want, the subscribe button as well. I do upload new comic book movies, superhero, anime content every week. So with that out of the way, let's jump right into Phase 4. So the first phase of the MCU was 6 films long, about 2 per year, and spanned 4 years, which was 2008 to 2012. Phase 2 was also 6 films in length and spanned 3 years, 2013 to 2015. Phase 3 lasted from 2016 to 2019, again 4 years, but here 11 movies. This phase grew the output to 3 per year. This last year saw the releases of Captain Marvel, Avengers Endgame, and Spider-Man Far From Home. This will also be the first year that the MCU has televised content to bolster it in any sort of significant capacity. I do know we had Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., Inhumans, and Agent Carter, and they did have some spillover, especially with Agent Coulson, but the shows were at best sort of peripheral support. Disney Plus launches in November of 2019. That's going to have shows like Falcon and Winter Soldier, a prequel show about Loki, WandaVision, which will be about Vision and Scarlet Witch, and a show focused on Hawkeye and Kate Bishop, as well as a What If series about alternate outcomes and events in the MCU. These Marvel TV shows will use main actors from the Marvel Studios side of the camp. Also, in the early part of 2019, Disney acquired Fox, which gave Marvel back the Fantastic Four and the X-Men, among a plethora of other content and franchises. However, in an interview with the website IO9, Kevin Feige had a few interesting comments. He said, "It's all beginning, and the 5-year plan that we've been working on, and we've been working on before any of that was set," meaning that merger. And then he goes on, "So really, it's much more for us, less about specifics of when and where," meaning when the X-Men will appear right now, and more just the comfort factor and how nice it is at their home that they're all back. But it will be a very long time, so I remember that point. Outside of contractual obligations, only characters to have gotten more than just a trilogy of 3 movies is the Avengers. Captain America and Iron Man both had 3 movies apiece, along with Thor. According to Variety, Robert Downey Jr. was only contracted until a 3rd Avengers film, but because of the nature of Civil War, his contract had to be renegotiated, which also included another Avengers film. However, that other Avengers film was split into 2 movies, which we know now are Infinity War and Endgame. This, plus the fact that he's the most expensive actor in the franchise, coupled with the fact that there's no more room on the release schedule, mean that Cap is most likely done. The only real successors to the mantle would be Winter Soldier or Falcon, but they'll both be busy over on Disney Plus. And same with Chris Evans and Chris Hemsworth. Reports say their contracts end in 2019. Actually came right from the source. Chris Evans said this, late 2018, "The contract's done. A lot of our contracts are through. Myself, Downey, and Hemsworth, we all started roughly at the same time, and I think we all, through Avengers 4, kind of wrap it up. I don't know what's next, but by 2019, that's it." And then he tweeted right around the same time, also indicating he's done. He said in his tweet, "Officially wrapped on Avengers 4, it was an emotional day to say the least. Playing this role over the last 8 years has been an honor to everyone in front of the camera, behind the camera, and in the audience. Thank you for the memories. Eternally grateful." That sounds pretty final to me. So this new slate sees Doctor Strange as the replacement for Iron Man, Black Panther for Thor, and Captain Marvel for Captain America. I've also heard talks of a 4th Thor movie. I think Taika and Hemsworth both think that there's more to say for the character, but it really would be quite some time before that saw the light of day. So you could also say for Downey, Hemsworth, and Evans, this is the end game. Yes, I went there. So we basically know now what Phase 4 won't include. It's reasonable to think that Marvel won't want to double up on the characters, so like no Loki standalone movie, no Scarlet Witch movie for a while, and also the X-Men will be off the board for a while. So what's next? Feige has been notoriously tight-lipped about what's in the development pipeline, and we likely won't get a real slate until after San Diego Comic-Con, possibly even Disney's D23 event later in 2019. So while we don't have any real confirmation from the Feige camp, we do know a few things already. So Phase 4 will take place between 2020 and 2024, so 5 years now instead of 4, and it will encompass 15 films for this phase. It will also represent a bit of a shift in the direction for the MCU. Kevin Feige actually said to Collider, "Everything after Endgame," he said, "and after Spider-Man Far From Home will be different and be unique, as we try to make every film. But seeing returning characters is certainly something we're going to do and want to do, but also introducing characters that the majority of the world has never heard of, much like Guardians, much like Avengers before we made Avengers, and there are lots of them. Eternals are one group, we'll remember that, but we like the idea of introducing an ensemble, doing an ensemble movie from the start, as opposed to building up as we did with the first Avengers, more like Guardians, not tonally, but in terms of introducing a new group of people." A couple years ago, James Gunn was talking about his Guardians of the Galaxy franchise, specifically the 3rd movie, which is now back on as Helmer after a hiccup with his employment, said, he was asked about Nova. He said, yes, definitely. Nova comes up occasionally as someone we might use. One of the things I'm doing with creating Guardians 3 will take place after the next two Avengers movies and will help to set up the next 10 to 20 years of Marvel movies. So it has to be towards the beginning of that, right? It's going to really expand the cosmic universe. We're going to be setting up new characters. It will be the last movie of this version of the Guardians of the Galaxy. So this would be obviously a perfect place to introduce like the new phase, the new Guardians team. You could tease the cosmic Eternals before their movie, the next year, revealing characters also like Nova and Warlock here would be a perfect place. Because of its proximity to the Disney Fox merger finalization, I wouldn't expect Silver Surfer or Galactus to show up here. The Eternals movie would be a perfect place to introduce someone like Galactus as a setup for like an Avengers 5 movie. Marvel's really good about planting seeds a few years before the actual movie comes out or that seed pays off. Silver Surfer as a herald of Galactus and a product of the acquisition of Fox and the FF could be easily introduced for the Eternals. Disney did release a release schedule for the first three of their 5 years for the phase. It's got TBA sort of as a placeholder. So 2020, we'll see May 1st, July 31st, and November 6th. 2021, you have May 7th, July 20th, and November 5th. And 2022 is February 18th, May 6th, and July 29th. So this will presumably be strict for the core MCU franchise. It won't include like already Deadpool or Sony Marvel movies like Morbius. R-rated Deadpool will be under a separate banner. Morbius is strictly Sony. Spider-Man, however, is a joint Sony-Marvel deal, so that we can include that here as they have in the past. Spider-Man movies typically come out in July, and so far it's been 2 years apart. 2019 is the last Spider-Man movie, so we could probably expect the next one July of 2021. Marvel's good with patterns. The pattern seems to be a couple cosmic movies a year and a grounded film. So now the focus will be on the next generation of Avengers, on cosmic teams, and a new looming threat. Now, with all that aside, there have been some announcements for a few movies. Kate Shortland is director for Black Widow. Destin Daniel Cretton's attached to the Shang-Chi movie. Chloe Zhao is directing a film called The Eternals, as well as confirmation that Scott Derrickson's back for Doctor Strange 2. Marvel's yet to make a film without at least one sequel, and predominantly they do a set of three. So we can be confident that we'll see another Black Panther movie, another Captain Marvel movie, maybe another Ant-Man movie down the road, like Ant-Man 3, or it might be in the form of Ant-Man and the Wasp 2, we don't know. Black Widow's already in production, and the script is done for Guardians 3 as well. In fact, it's been finished for quite some time. So those would most likely come out in 2020. Gunn was actually rehired well before it was made official. So we had plenty of time for rewrites and punch-ups. Guardians 1 and 2 came out in August and May, respectively. The original plan before Gunn was fired was for May 2020 release. So I'm going to presume that that film is going to maintain its previous date, despite the hiccup. Doctor Strange 1 came out at the end of October, so I would attribute the sequel to a similar time frame, which would mean it would take the November 2020 spot. And there's lots of talk about Kate Shortland's Black Widow movie being out early in the phase, so we can put that in the July spot. And I could see the Eternals movie spinning out of the conclusion of Guardians, since they're both heavily cosmic in nature. It also makes sense that the Eternals is where the mutants would be introduced, because they tie into the Celestials, into the Deviants, and the start of the Homo sapiens on planet Earth. And it could be a new cosmic franchise to take the place of Guardians. Captain Marvel came out in March of 2019, so it'll be some time before a sequel sees the silver screen, putting it in 2022 at the earliest. The early summer blockbuster season now includes April and May. Those are reserved for those like bona fide money makers, like the Avengers movies, for example. They all came out during this time frame. The next phase will be need a new big bad as well to build towards now that Thanos will be done. And this is not a spoiler because I'm recording this a week before I see Endgame. We had two Avengers movies, large ensemble films, and back-to-back years, so probably won't get a large movie like that again for another couple years, putting that Avengers 5 out to like 2022. Scott Derrickson tweeted out and quickly deleted an image of Fear Itself the Deep, which featured Doctor Strange and Namor on the cover. Namor might be a protagonist because of this for Doctor Strange. If not there, I would say surely Ryan Coogler's Black Panther 2 and Wakanda. There will be an additional 6 films for 2023 and 2024. The dates haven't been released, but that'll likely include X-Men, Fantastic Four, maybe Avengers versus X-Men, something like that. It's also still the matter of a big bad, thinking it might be Annihilus or Galactus. And then there'll be an R-rated banner as well, where things like Deadpool and Blade and Moon Knight, Midnight Suns, even something like Man-Thing would most likely go. So I could see Marvel making that announcement in a couple of years. But back to Phase 4, in terms of release dates, here's what I think for 2020. May 1st, Guardians 3. They'll introduce Nova and Warlock there. July 31st, 2020, Black Widow. November 6th, 2020, Doctor Strange 2. Seems like they might introduce Namor there. The next year, the next three films, May 7th, 2021, The Eternals. That may be where we get the mutants and the X-Men. July 30th, 2021, Spider-Man 3, subtitle something something with home in it. November 5th, 2021, Captain Marvel 2, where we'll also see the debut of Kamala Khan. That's it for 2021. 2022, February 18th, Black History Month, Black Panther 2. Black Panther saw a tremendous success in the February timeframe. I think that they would want to repeat that success. May 6th, 2022, which is the huge Avengers month. Avengers 5, which might be Secret Invasion or Secret War or something like that. And then July 29th, 2022, I predict Shang-Chi, Master of Kung Fu, will be released. But now it's your turn. I want to know your theories, your ideas, so go ahead and leave those in the comments below. As always, thank you for watching and listening. If you're here and haven't already, hit that subscribe button so you'll be the first to know when we upload new content each week. I'm Jesse, this is JLS Comics, and I'll see you soon.